fight too! Gaze upon my fiery mirrors! Kaleido Spray! We've gotta get out of here! Let's get started!
Boy who called himself Enominot. Could he really be Velvet's younger brother?
It could have been an illusion intended to torment her. Don't you agree, Eleanor?
I do. Velvet's objective is avenging her brother, after all. We've all seen how strongly she feels about it. I find it hard to believe that the one so dear to her is still alive.
I don't know what powers Enominot possesses, but I think that really was her little brother. Velvet was able to see past Melchior's illusions. But look at her now. I just don't want to believe that the real Lafi could do such a thing.
Could it be possible that Enominot was reborn into her brother's body?
I don't know. But if that was the case, I'm not sure Velvet would be in so much agony.
Yes, I guess. Enominot actually being Velvet's brother. It makes a twisted sort of sense. But it's too awful.
It's okay. I'm tired.
Have you been journeying long, then?
10 years. My master entrusted everything to me. But I couldn't do anything.
10 years?
My wings are weak. It doesn't matter anymore.
I see. If you've been working that hard, you surely need a break. I just happened to get my hands on some prickle boar meat. I'll be cooking up a stew for dinner. But would you care to join me?
Huh? No way.
All I have on me now is this apple. Here. Once your belly is full of warm food, you'll be able to pick yourself back up. I can feel it. Your body is shouting, "I want to live."
I'm a disgrace. I don't deserve to live.
Is life something you have to earn? To deserve?
Well...
these feelings are natural. You eat when you're hungry and cry when you're sad. Feeling these things is proof that we're alive.
Alive?
What's your name? Mine is Celica. Celica Crow.
I'm an exorcist. Artori... no, Arthur. I'm Arthur.
Artorias!
What in the world was that?
Rokuro! Aizen!
You saw it too then?
Sure did. Artorias. And he called himself Arthur.
I've heard of this. The Earth in Historia. They say that events on the world's surface cast imprints on the Earth pulse that runs below.
In other words, an illusion of the past.
It's not an illusion. That was my sister. So, he managed to fool her too, is it? Yes. Yes, that must be it. That's why she freed me from the prison.
Rokuro, have you recovered from your wounds?
Yep. Tough as nails. That's old Rokuro. I'm more worried about Velvet. Is she okay?
How could she be okay? Inominat is reborn, and it's her little brother.
A blade can't just be hard. It's gotta be flexible, or it'll snap the first time it meets an unexpected force. I misunderstood the true meaning of strength, and so did he.
Let's just worry about ourselves for now. This Earth Pulse is completely under Inominat's domain. We can think of it as an extension of his body.
Yeah, which means my power won't get us out of here.
Be wary. Inominat may be the one showing us these memories. Remember, he's after Velvet.
And the two types of malevolence inside her.
True. And we may be able to use that against him to get us out of here.
What are you saying? Just use her?
If it's necessary.
We have to keep moving. Nothing will be gained by staying here. And we ought to look for Magilu. Even she doesn't deserve to be stuck here forever. So, what is this Earth in Historia you mentioned?
As I've said, an Earth Pulse is a natural force that circulates within the land. Wind blows, water flows, birds fly, flowers bloom. All actions in nature leave their mark on the Earth Pulse. These marks become etched within the land itself and remain a part of the Earth Pulse, like memories.
So it's a record of the world's past.
Does it remember human and Moloch deeds?
Everything that occurs is part of nature, including the acts of humans, Malachim, and even demons.
So that means that even this very conversation is being recorded in the Earth in Historia?
Anything bad I've done in secret, any insults you've ever told behind someone's back, the land sees it all.
My insults?
It's just an example. Pay it no mind.
Does that mean that Inominat is drawing specific memories from the Earth in Historia and showing them to Velvet?
I believe so. That's how Rokuro and I saw the same thing, even though we weren't there. With the Earth itself as his vessel, it's a trick only Inomina could pull off.
Awfully devious for a self-styled Empyrean.
But the attack did strike home. Keep a close watch on her until we're out of the Earth Pulse.
Right.
Welcome home, Arthur.
Hi, Celica. I fixed the fence around the house.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart. With the brigands stepping up their attacks, the town elders have been worried. But this should put their minds at ease.
No. If the brigands turn into demons, a mere fence won't stop them. Nothing. Don't worry about it. I'm pretty confident in my carpentry. And the other two?
Probably at the Cape again. I've warned them 100 times that it's dangerous.
Luffy set probably Badgered Velvet into going. Don't worry, she'll watch out for him.
Yeah. I can only hope that this little one grows up to be as strong as she is one day.
Huh?
You're happy, I hope.
Of course I am. I never thought I could ever be this happy.
I only wish I'd known earlier. I would have made something even nicer for you.
Oh, you made this for me?
Yeah. I put all my heart into it.
I'll cherish it always. It'll remind me of this happy day.
Let this serve as proof of our love. This I swear. I swear to protect you both with my life.
That's Lord Artorias's past.
Oh, that's rich! You mean you believe that tripe?
It's all a pack of lies. His smile. His promise. Everything.
Up his lies without questioning a word.
What a joke.
Velvet didn't know those things about Artorias and Celica. Did she?
Probably not. That was when the two were alone and first getting to know each other.
We were seeing glimpses of a warm, loving family. But really, it just gave me the creeps.
Same here. I could keenly feel Inominat scheming behind everything we saw.
He's trying to get at Velvet.
I think she used to truly love Lord Artorias. Having that happy past thrust in front of her at a time like this must be tearing her apart.
Probably, but a demon like me wouldn't understand.
What Velvet is going through is horrible. Even as a human, I can scarcely imagine what it must be like. But I approach it, just a little bit, because like her, I was his pupil.
Artorias said he needed two types of malevolence to awaken Inominat. The illusions at a ball, making sure we knew about the attack on Titania, and Inominat appearing as her brother. If all of that was planned to extract the malevolence from her, we'd all better brace for worse to come.
Many of them. Celica, I'm coming!
It's too late! Take Velvet and Lafayette and run!
I can't do that! I want to have my life with you, with our child! Why? Why couldn't I? Why couldn't I protect my own family?
Remember this moment well, Artorias. Humans are weak, filled with sin.
Melchior!
The people of this village offered you and your beloved family up to the demon brigands. A sacrifice so that they could escape and hide.
No, they wouldn't.
It happens often. The reason people act on is burdened by the weight of their sins. However, I have found a method to adjust their reason.
Adonai, what is this incredible power? Don't tell me the Empyrean we've been searching for was here this whole time. These Molochim.
So they have been reborn. But be not deceived. They are not the same people you knew.
Why? Why must fate be so cruel?
It appears that Innominat's resurrection is incomplete. We must guide him until we understand why. I'll be taking these Malakim.
Wait! Sorry, I couldn't keep my promise. I'll make things right. I'll abandon who I am. Nameless Moloch, I will forge a pact with you. I will put an end to all the pain in this world.
Do you have it in you? You, who abandoned my friend's ideals and fled.
On the souls of my dead master, wife, and child, this I swear. My name is Artorias Colbrand. I have inherited the will and the strength of Claudin Asgard, former head of the Exorcists.
Very well. Let tonight's tragedy change fate and birth salvation.
That Moloch! It was me! You don't remember?
Not at all.
They said you were reborn as a Moloch. That means... what exactly?
The soul of a human who passed away can, given the right trigger, be reborn as a Moloch.
You're saying that Artorias' child was reborn as Lafayette?
If what we saw was real, yes.
So the female Moloch that was born along with him was...
my sister's reincarnation. But I ate her long ago.
You didn't know, right?
I knew. I had already caught on to who Ceres really was.
Velvet.
But it doesn't matter. What does it change? I'll devour anything to fulfill my goal. My sister. My brother. Even the world. That's who I am. That's all I am.
Aizen, you said a human soul can be reborn as a Moloch given the right trigger, right? Is that something that happens frequently?
I'm afraid I don't have an answer for that. We know that humans are sometimes reborn as Malakim, but not how or why. It's more likely among people with greater resonance, but the process is still a mystery.
Huh. So it's not something that happens, or that can be made to happen, easily. Ordinarily, at least.
But Velvet's sister was reborn as Ceres, and her unborn child came back as Lafayette. What are the chances of that?
It might not have been chance. They both died on the Scarlet Night. Their rebirths may have been influenced by the sacrificial ceremony.
Are you saying that Innominat made it happen on purpose?
Call it an educated guess. But I don't think even an Empyrean can control the lives of humans or Malakim at his whim.
If it wasn't chance, it might have been destiny.
Velvet said she ate Ceres, her own sister reborn as a Moloch. How could such a horrible thing be destiny?
Sorry. I didn't mean to make light of a tragedy, but our fates intertwine, the good and the bad, whether we like it or not. That's what makes it destiny, right?
True. But this...
Get a hold of yourself, Eleanor. Velvet and Lafayette are in rougher waters than any of us. They'll be looking to you to light their way.
Yes. I must remain calm and steady.
An Earth Pulse Rift. We may be able to get out from there.
Arthur, there's something I'd like to speak to you about. Alone. Two souls possessing powerful resonance and free of malevolence. These must be sacrificed on the Scarlet Night.
Ah, yes. The ceremony to resurrect Denominat. You read my book.
I haven't fully mastered the ancient tongue yet, but I have read your notes. You wrote that if Enominat is resurrected, we can make a world free of demons.
7 years ago, a soul with strong resonance, my own unborn son, was sacrificed for that purpose. Now, Enominat's resurrection is half complete.
Because of that, everyone's resonance has grown stronger, enabling them to see demons.
Yes, that's the truth behind the opening.
So, if one more person is sacrificed...
Enominat's resurrection will be complete, and his power will spur the creation of many new exorcists.
And there is another Scarlet Knight very soon. Arthur, I must ask.
Lafayette?
Can't I be the sacrifice?
Tell me, why do you think that birds fly?
I think that birds fly because they must. Why else would they have wings if not to embrace the sky? I have wings too. Weak as they are. That's why I must fly. Now! If we miss this Scarlet Night, the next won't be for another 3 years. By then, I won't be alive.
Lafayette, why would you say such a thing?
The 12-year sickness. That's the name of my disease.
So you know.
I'm not afraid of being sick. But I don't want to just be a burden on everyone until I die. I couldn't take it.
Your wings are your will. And they are strong.
Lars. Please. You can't tell Velvet about this.
Promise.
I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Don't talk to me about will! About wings! Both of you! Together! You! You betrayed me!
Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right? Hurry back! I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me. No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him.
Shut up!
He fell further than this back at the shrine. I will have my revenge.
Revenge for Lafayette!
Lafayette knew so much more pain than I ever will. And still, I couldn't do anything for him. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Shut up! It's a lie! A dirty lie! All of it! It's all their lies! And I believed it! Die! Get out of my way, you disgusting monster!
What is this thing?
An amalgamation of multiple...
Killing Flash!
But I'm just close. I want this! Form Zero! Thunder!
Crash through! Turn back!
Die!
This farce is just another of Venominat's illusions!
Farce? How callous. That farce is the true face of my sister. She hates, resents, devours, and kills. She tramples people, cities, everything, living only by her emotions. What an ugly, tainted soul.
It's not like that!
Nothing you say will matter. She knows. She knows if it's the truth.
He's right. Just think, everything I did was baseless, arrogant. And even so, I still...
You hurt so many innocent people, didn't you?
More than I can count. I devoured and killed so many.
Without even knowing Arthur's true aims.
I destroyed people. I destroyed whole towns.
And worse yet, you didn't even show mercy to your own sister's reincarnation.
I... hate her!
And despite all of that, I still love you, Velvet. That's why I chose to become a sacrifice. For you, sister. But think, if you try to stop the resurrection, wouldn't my death be all for nothing? To tell you the truth, I was terrified of dying. It was so dark.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You'll accept it then? That everything you've done up until this point, all of it...
Yes. It was all for nothing and for no one. I hurt so many people. All for no reason. I'm a monster.
If you've accepted it, you have to atone for your sins. Once I eat the final two malevolences inside you, I'll fully awaken. Give them to me. Give me your hatred, your despair. If you do, I can cleanse this world of all its pain. I had hoped that you could live in a world without pain and sadness. But you're a monster now. You don't belong there.
Velvet!
Let me go. We have to go. If you don't, you'll die too for no reason.
No!
A twisted monster like me doesn't deserve to live. Don't you understand?
You're the reincarnation of the first sacrifice. Part of me. Don't worry, I'll devour you too.
Lafayette, tell this self-absorbed idiot what she needs to hear!
Please, let me go.
Will you stop whining? Huh? No, I don't understand! You snap at people! You're scary! You tried to eat me! But you're also kind! And you're filled with life! I don't understand a single thing about you! Huh. But you gave me a name!
protect you for my own sake!
Fee...
I don't care if you're malevolent, or if it was pointless! If the world says it's a mistake to love you, I'll fight the whole world! I don't care how much pain you feel! It doesn't matter! A world without you, Velvet! Is the one thing I couldn't bear!
Let me go. My hand will... I loved them all. I loved Luffy and Celica, Arthur, everyone. To have it all stolen from me. Why them? Why not me? It hurts so much!
Your despair, how is it gone?
A flame burns in my heart, too. A flame I cannot quench, no matter how hard I try. Just like you, Velvet.
I finally understand how you felt. But the only one I can fight for is myself.
That's good enough. That's proof that you are truly alive.
How many times do you plan to destroy and rebuild your own heart, Moggy Lou?
We're on 107. Who was it, 108? I lost count. Not that I really care.
Pathetic fool. Did I not tell you it would require an iron will as indomitable as the very trees that live and die across millennia?
Like you, I suppose. Or that boy over there?
That is the foundation of an ideal world. One free from man's sins.
An ideal world, huh? You, kid. The boy who was your companion, Lafayette. He's alive. Chasing a terrifying demon girl, he has learned the immensity of the seas and weathered the dry wastes of the land. Those people, they're different from us. Despite the pain, the anguish, they embrace the life they've been given. They live, undaunted by the ugliness of the world!
So you're doing this all for them? Is that what this is?
Not even close. They aggravate me to my wit's end. Like stabs in the chest, over and over and over. And that's exactly why. That's why. I intend to see how all of this ends. I won't be satisfied until I do.
Words bereft of meaning. You truly are my greatest failure.
Gosh, funny just how little I care. No! Please!
Let me guess. We came at a good time?
You're late. Because of you, I had to have a really boring conversation.
So, you came face to face with Innominat. If so, then you must know that your quest for revenge is utterly meaningless.
Yeah, I did. I know why sadness fills the world, and I know how deep are the burdens of sin. I tried to abandon my memories of Arthur and Laffy, to cut myself off from it all, and end this tragedy. It's what they would have wanted.
Exactly. You do well to know your place.
But that's exactly why I can't forgive them. Not Artorias, not Innominat. I know my heart is ugly and full of contradictions. But those days we spent together in familial warmth, they're proof that I, that all of us, were truly alive. That's why, no matter how hard, no matter how sad it gets, I will take my vengeance to the very end!
Velvet!
Don't be a fool! Just give up and die like you ought! It is your destiny to wallow in despair!
You take my family, turn me into a monster, and you want my soul too? Now who's being the fool? Remember this well. The Lord of Calamity never gives up, not even in the face of death.
Have you no shame for your sins, you unholy monster?
Let me in on this. I lost a bet, and I've got some anger to work out.
You sure you can fight in your condition?
I thought you'd never ask. I am the dastardly witch Moggy Lou, scourge of self-righteous exorcists! Now face the wrath of Moggy Lou Maven!
Fools, all of you!
Everyone, sorry to have worried you.
I wasn't worried.
I didn't realize you were someone who needed looking after.
Me neither.
This is our way of saying we trust you.
Yeah.
You horrible ingrates! See? Step to the chest, that's all you give me. Crash through!
Yes! Cherry blast!
But I'm this close, I won't hit!
Form zero! Thunder! Double haste! No hit!
Yes!
Artorias and Nominat. They took something precious from me. I'll never forgive them for that.
The annals of history are stained with evil people like you. You spread havoc and destruction all to satisfy your own ends. A dark font of malevolence. You're a demon lord, the irredeemable embodiment of sin.
The Lord of Calamity.
It is the Exorcist's duty to destroy you!
You talk a lot. How about you keep talking and tell us where Ifrit is?
You'll regret this.
I can feel Enominat! He's coming!
We can fight here no longer!
The Enfu, close the rift!
I can't!
Come forth!
Carelessness will get you killed.
Zavid!
You ruined the moment.
Huh? Don't you mean, thanks for saving us, Zavid? You're my hero and role model.
Thank you for saving us, Zavid.
Where exactly are we now?
We're in an abbey facility on Hexen Isle. I heard Melchior was in charge here. So I snuck in. I hadn't expected an extra-dimensional space.
Is there a way out?
There is now that I busted my way in.
Let's head outside. We can talk then.
Who's that?
A friend. His name is Number One.
Hey, wanna come with us? If you stay here alone, a dragon might get you. I bet you wouldn't like that.
Yeah, that sounds scary.
Great! Come on, kid.
What are you doing?
We can't leave him like this. I'll get him a vessel, somehow.
Do what you like.
You seem awfully chipper, Velvet.
I'm fine. And I guess I have you to thank as well.
Perhaps. But gratitude doesn't suit you. Now, say ah!
Huh?
I need to see your teeth! I made 100 gold bet that you'd break, remember? So, I need to see if you've broken anything. Let's start with those teeth. Help us out, kiddo.
All right. I just need to check our front teeth, right?
Front teeth, canines, whatever. Just get in there and take a good, hard look.
You didn't mean that literally, did you? Why are you making Fee do the checking?
Acting the innocent maiden, are we? Well, I suppose that some say that showing the inside of your mouth can be more personal than being seen naked.
What? Seriously?
Mogilu, you're only making this even more awkward.
Come now, will you cooperate or not? We can't settle the bet until we know the tooth.
Fine, but let's check the ones in my left hand first.
Good. I believe Bianfu can assist with that.
Why me? Leave me out of this! Bian! She's squeezing me! Ouch! Those fangs hurt!
Looks like Velvet is just fine.
Yeah, the sparks returned to her eyes. But, is showing the inside of your mouth really that embarrassing?
What? Keep your intrusive questions to yourself! The size of the art that created this place. Just what is the Abbey planning to use it for?
Whatever it is, they're trying hard to keep it hidden. Can't be anything good. Hey, who was that kid anyway?
He and I used to be tethered to an exorcist named Lady Teresa. He was number one, I was number two.
Oh, a friend of yours then. So he went feral after that Teresa lady fell.
Yeah. I found Velvet and the others, but he probably had nowhere to go.
A stray Moloch stripped of his free will won't go much further than a demon's belly. Anyway, seems like the only people I run into these days are kids. I'm more in the market for an unattached woman with a pretty face.
Sorry?
I'm just fooling around. Grow a sense of humor, kid. Anyway, relax. I'll keep an eye on him until he's in command of himself again, all right? Just one more reason to bring the Abbey down.
Right. Thanks, Avid.
Lafayette, can you think of a good name for the kid?
You're giving number one a name?
Yeah. He says he can't remember his true name, and calling him by a number seems mean, you know?
Yeah. I was really happy when Velvet gave me my name.
Hey, I've got this. How about Hajime? It means the first, and he's number one, right?
In that case, why not just go with Ichiro?
No way. That was Shigure's childhood name.
Why should that matter to us?
It should be softer. How about Ichi? Or maybe something like Numbi?
Numbi? Where'd that one come from?
It's like number, but, more cute.
Let's just forget that one.
I don't think we should reference his old number at all.
How about Bob?
Is that just because of his hairstyle? That's really reaching. Actually, I kind of like it. If it's too plain, how about Bobby?
That isn't bad.
Right? Then number one is hereby renamed.
Stop it, you two! You don't understand it at all!
A boy doesn't want a name that sounds cute.
You don't think so?
That was quite an outburst.
The kid has a point. You need something with more panache.
How about Silva?
Silva?
His hair and pendant are both silver.
I like it. It's got a certain mystique about it.
Silva. Yeah, it sounds cool.
Well, if his old buddy Lafayette approves, then Silva it is. Well done, first mate.
Praise from you is wasted on me.
Huh. Inconsiderate praise from Silva instead. Right. Time to go give him the good news. Hey! The Moloch formerly known as Number One. You've got a new name.
I'm glad he got a good name.
Maybe we should have put a little more thought into naming you, too.
That's all right. You need to steer your own ship. Right, Aizen? You're the one who taught me that.
You know just what to say, don't you? Moloch, formerly known as Number Two.
On to battle!
Ready to clash your hair in there! Whoa there! Fall back and regroup!
Dragon!
It looks like it's been captured. Just like the Therians.
But why would they hold a dragon captive?
An art connects this place to the Earth Pulse. That's probably why we were taken here.
Earth Pulse. So it's got something to do with Enominat?
That would be the obvious conclusion.
I don't get it. Explain. Small words.
Very well. You're part of all this, too.
Velvet.
I'm fine now. I promise.
All right.
I see. You found out Enominat's true identity. So, now that you know, can you still fight him?
It's only given me more reason to kill him. And the Shepherd.
You're one ice-cold girl.
There's still one thing bothering me. Enominat needs to eat malevolence to awaken. Once he does, he'll use his power to suppress negative emotions. But when humans can't create any more malevolence, what will happen to Enominat?
He'll run out of things to eat. And maybe die?
Wouldn't he just go back to sleep?
But if he does, then his power will fade and humanity will start creating malevolence again, right?
In order for Enominat to eternally suppress negative emotions...
He needs an infinite, powerful source of malevolence to feed off of. For example, that produced by an immortal dragon.
Which would make this place a sort of dragon farm, created so he could control humanity forever.
You can't be serious!
Just speculation, but it all makes sense.
They can't think of Malakim as anything but tools.
Just how much will they sacrifice for their ideal world of tranquility?
We don't dare free it. It'd be too dangerous.
I know. Damn the Abbey and their twisted morality.
Velvet?
What is it?
I was once your sister's child, right? Then my father is...
Look, you were reborn, right?
Yeah.
Honestly, I really don't know anything about how being reborn works. But to me, what you see, what you hear, and what you feel, that's what's important. Whoever we used to be in another life, I'm me now, and you're you. That's all there is to it.
Velvet.
That's true. Aizen said that not all Malakim are humans who have been reborn, right?
Does that mean they could be reincarnations of birds or fish or beasts?
That's not true! So, if a boy was a dog in a past life, that wouldn't make him part of the dog's family now.
Yeah. I'm me, I guess.
But you're Velvet's cute little pup, aren't ya?
Moggy Lou.
Be careful. I bite.
Oh, have mercy! I take it all back, just don't bite me!
Rebirth is like the Earth in Historia. You're simply built on a larger foundation. But that's not special. Everyone's lives are founded on the past.
So, I'm just me.
Yep. You're you, and no one else. You're Fee.
I came here by ship. It's anchored by the southeast beach.
I can fight too!
Oh, hold on! Helicopter!
Fight another day!
What happened?
We used to play tag all the time. I won't let you get away, Velvet.
Inomina!
That was the whole reason I took him from Teresa. It's just another necessary sacrifice for peace.
Inominat, you monster!
Inominat to the front of us, a dragon to the back of us. Reaper's curse doesn't begin to describe it. What a shame. Is that despair I sense?
Not on your life.
It'll take more than this to make your big sister break.
The more you resist, the more you'll suffer.
Velvet, let me punish this rotten little delinquent.
You're just a Malak. You don't stand a chance.
I'm not just any Malak. And I'm sick of murdering scum like you. I know no limits! For I am Sabine! Sabine!
This is officially too damn much.
We'll be fine. Take them out one by one!
If only I'd been a larger vessel.
Save your regrets for later. We're dead if we don't focus.
Aye. Bringing him a swift death would be a mercy.
Crash through! Crash through! Crash through!
Told you would suffer.
Safeed.
I'll hold off, you know me not. Everyone else, take out that dragon.
There's no way you can face him alone. At least let me assist you.
This isn't an order, it's strategy.
I'm counting on you, Fee.
For something that's a mere part of me, you're awfully uppity.
I am the Malak Mafiset. I am my own master!
I miscalculated before. I won't hold back this time.
And neither will we!
It's changed! We're still in the same bind!
Everything's...
No mercy!
Wounds I will see!
Friend!
again!
No, it's not!
You talk big, but you're struggling even to protect yourself. If you apologize now, I'll make sure it doesn't hurt when I devour you.
No way I'm apologizing! Not to some jerk who doesn't understand how Velvet feels!
And you're saying that you do? She's my sister.
I know everything, but I won't tell you!
So be it. If I devour you, we'll be one again anyway!
The compass!
She isn't yours! Velvet is Velvet!
And you're just a fragment of me!
So that was your strategy.
Hey! Give us more warning! You almost roasted us alive!
You've really done it now. I'll turn you into a dragon. See who's left in time! What's going on?
We're leaving! Hurry!
They got away.
A silver flame. A strange art that Moloch used.
Did you forget that you have the power to digest malevolence? That thing may be a fragment, but it's still part of you.
But the dragon attacked me. If it hadn't disrupted my concentration like that, I never would have let my fragment lay a finger on me.
So long as you learn from your mistake, such a ruse won't work a second time. After all, Malakim are mere servants of the Empyreans. As long as we stay wary, they pose no threat to our ideal world.
Your awakening is nearly complete. None within your domain can stand against you without the power of the four elemental Empyreans. And they are fast asleep, far beneath the earth pulses.
I'm going after them.
No, not now. We need to make preparations for the ceremony of suppression.
We'll send this one after them instead.
A demon? Will he be reliable?
True, he can be hard to control. Even after he succumbed to demonhood, he withstood my illusions for 7 days and nights. Even now, he resists on an instinctual level. However, he used to be known as the most fearsome pirate in all the seas. His strength is equal to any legate's. You. Capture the Therian Velvet. Do whatever you have to, as long as you keep her alive.
Wait. First...
First, kill him. Kill Lafiset. Before my sister's eyes. He's the only thing keeping her from falling to despair. It's true. Demon or not, he still possesses an odd sort of pride. I'll have to relieve him of such a meaningless burden.
Well, that made for good training, at least. We fought an Armatus, an Empyrean, and a dragon. It's a miracle we're still alive.
It's all thanks to Fi.
He's still asleep. He must have used all his physical and mental strength. A fire that burns away malevolence. That's quite the talent he's got there.
Is it because he's part of Inominot?
Sure could be. In one sense, that's a lucky break for us. But on the other hand... Anyway, I lost that bet. And I was so sure I was gonna win, too.
Awful lot of drama you're making over 100 gold.
Don't you dare laugh off 100 gold! One with no respect for gold will be by 20 lions mauled. Everyone knows that.
Right. Anyway, what do we do next?
Nothing's changed. We seal Inominot away and kill Artorias. Even if Inominot has awakened, there must be a way to seal him back again.
Our best lead is still Grimoire's ancient book. We should meet up with Benwick and the others.
Are you sure you want to stay with us?
I don't know if it's the right choice or not. But I refuse to believe Lord Artorias is right. That sacrifices are inevitable bumps on the road to a better world. That's why I'll do what I believe is right, and fight him. Even if I'm wrong, I won't have any regrets.
Do you have any idea how frustrating you are?
You're one to talk.
Aizen, get in touch with Benwick and the others.
That demon. It had to have been...
Aizen?
I think we need a break more than anything. That was a long stretch of battle.
Seconded. Besides, the boy and Zavid aren't waking up anytime soon.
Let's find a place to sleep for tonight. Eleanor, look after Lafayette.
Maybe you ought to carry him. He did all this for you.
Please.
Very well.
You can at least carry the poor kid. Damn, you're cold.
No, quite the opposite.